The White Abalone Captive Breeding Program is based at the Bodega Marine Lab in Bodega Bay. The main goal of our program is to breed as many white abalone as we can in captivity, figure out how to improve how we're breeding them, and then get those abalone out into the wild. In 2001, when the species was listed as endangered, scientists decided that the only way to save the species was to bring animals in captivity and breed them. And that's because abalone are broadcast spawners and they have separate sexes, which means that males and females will spawn or release eggs or sperm into the water column. And the sperm and eggs need to be close enough together for them to mix and form embryos. White abalone are important because they are grazers in kelp forest ecosystems, kind of creating space for other algae to grow. And people who live in California also have fond connection to abalone.
The only remaining animal from the first cohort ever produced at BML.
White Abalone Culture Lab, so my lab, and the Shellfish Health Lab, which is part of CDFW, together do a ton of work to help save the species. A huge part of that is disease management.
My lab is to maintain the health of the animals here at BML as well as our partner facilities. And in maintaining health, that means that we're testing them for specific pathogens as well as providing feedback if someone sees something unusual.
During the spawning process, there's a volunteer who usually stares over the bins the abalone is sitting in, and they're looking for sperm and eggs. And as soon as the sperm and eggs are produced, the solution is dumped out, seawater is put in, and those sperm and eggs are released into the seawater solution. They are collected with a sterile transfer pipette, and then they are combined to form embryos in a certain density. So that way we can produce the babies that will be outplanted one day.